In part two of our lesson on simple harmonic motion, you will learn how to write a position function that models a given displacement. In this example, you have to find a function in the form of S of t equals a cosine of omega t, or S of t equals a sine of omega t, given that S of 0 is equal to negative 5 inches, and the period is equal to 0.75 seconds. It's a great idea to make a picture to help you think your way through the problem. So we'll start by getting a coordinate plane going. We know that the initial position, meaning at time equals 0, the height is negative 5 inches. So it's starting out at negative 5, and this is in inches, which means the highest that it can go is going to be positive 5. Since it's starting out at negative 5, and we know it has to be a cosine or a sine, we know this is going to be a negative cosine. Now we're told that the period for the function is 0.75 seconds. So now we know we're going to be using this. S of t is equal to a cosine omega t. So S of t is equal to, we know the amplitude is 5, and because it's flipped over, a is going to have to be negative 5 times the cosine. To find omega, we can use the period. We know that 2 pi over omega has to equal the period, which is 0.75, and we can write that as 3/4. We know that 0.75 is the same as 3/4. The 4 in this equation will cross multiply up to the 2 pi, so that will become 8 pi. The 3 will cross multiply down. The omega will cross multiply up, and we now know that omega is 8 pi over 3. So we put that into our equation. The argument of the cosine function will be 8 pi over 3 times t. So now we have our position function. In part B, we have to calculate and interpret S of 7 over 16. Now we know this means that T is equal to 7 over 16 seconds, and we'll plug that into the function and find out what S is. S of 7 over 16 means we have to take negative 5 times the cosine of 8 pi over 3 times 7 over 16. We can reduce the 8 and 16. We know that 8 goes into 16 twice. So this becomes negative 5 times the cosine of 7 pi over 6. Using the unit circle, we see that the cosine of 7 pi over 6 is equal to negative rad 3 over 2. So we get positive 5 radical 3 over 2 inches, because s is in units of inches. Now, to interpret that, because s worked out to be positive, we know that means the object is above the equilibrium point. So we can say the object is 5 radical 3 over 2 inches above equilibrium. In part C, we're being asked, when is the first time the object is 2.5 inches above equilibrium? So what that's really asking us to do is find out, when does S of T equal 2.5? That's the question that's being asked. Now we know that S of T is negative 5 cosine of 8 pi over 3 times T, and we have to set that equal to 2.5. So dividing the left-hand side by negative 5 and dividing the right-hand side by negative 5, we get cosine of 8 pi over 3 times t has to equal negative 1/2, right? 2.5 divided by 5 is a half when we've got that negative sign there. So what this is asking us to do is, we know that the cosine of something, let's just use A for any argument, the cosine of an argument has to equal negative 1/2. And as you think your way around the unit circle, we can see that the very first time that the cosine of something is negative 1/2 is when the angle is 2 pi over 3. So that means we come back to our equation and say that the argument of our cosine function, which is 8 pi over 3 times t, has to equal the angle where that will happen, which is 2 pi over 3. So we will multiply the left-hand side and the right-hand side by the reciprocal of the coefficient, so 3 over 8 pi on the left-hand side, 3 over 8 pi on the right-hand side. We get t is equal to, the 3's are going to cancel, the pi's are going to cancel, and 2 goes into 8 4 times, so t is equal to 1/4 of a second. In this example, we have to find a function in the form of S of t equals A cosine omega t, or S of t equals A sine of omega t, to model the displacement. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. Now in part A, we're given that S of 0 equals 0. So that means at t is equal to 0, time is 0, the position of the function is that it is at 0, the height of the function. So as I always suggest, let's make a little picture. So we'll start off with a coordinate plane. We can plot the initial position of the function at 0. Now that tells us already that it's going to be some sort of a sine wave, and then we just have to decide if it's going to be positive or negative. We're told that the frequency is equal to 60 cycles per second, so we can jot that down. We're also given the clue that the object moves upward first. So given that we've decided it was a sine wave and it's going to go upward first, we know that it's going to be a positive sine wave. So we can get that drawn in. We're told that the maximum displacement is 12 centimeters. So we know the max is 12 centimeters, which means the min is going to be negative 12. Now, because we were given that the frequency was 60, that means we're going to be able to find omega, because we know frequency is omega divided by 2 pi, so that will have to equal 60, which means omega is going to equal 120 pi. And now we can fill in our equation. We're using the sine model, so S of t is going to equal A, which we know to be positive 12, since this is a positive sine, times the sine of omega is 120 pi times t. So here is our position function that we'll be using. In part B, we have to calculate and interpret S of 1 over 96. Remember, that means T is equal to 1 over 96 seconds. Very short time here. So S of 1 over 96 is going to equal 12 times the sine of 120 pi times 1 over 96, which is 12 times the sine of, well, let's figure out this argument. It might not be obvious to you what the greatest common factor is, so you can start knocking it down. These are both even numbers, so clearly we could divide by 2, so this would become 60, and this would become 48. Both of these are divisible by 12, so this would become 60 divided by 12 is equal to 5, 48 divided by 12 is equal to 4. So this argument would reduce to 5 pi over 4. Then this will become 12 times, we can use our unit circle to find the sine of 5 pi over 4 is negative radical 2 over 2. So this works out to be negative 6 radical 2, and the units are centimeters. Next, we have to interpret this result. The position is negative, so we know that means the object is 6 radical 2 centimeters below equilibrium. And now in part C, it asks, when is the first time the object is 6 radical 3 centimeters below equilibrium? So this is asking, when does S of t equal negative 6 rad 3? We know that S of t is 12 times the sine of 120 pi t, and that has to equal negative 6 radical 3. We will divide both sides by 12, and we've got sine of 120 pi t has to equal negative rad 3 over 2. We can go off on the side now and think, when does the sine of anything equal negative rad 3 over 2 for the first time? And using our unit circle, we see that the first time that the sine of an angle is negative rad 3 over 2 is when the angle is 4 pi over 3. So we will come back to our equation here and say that we need our argument, which is 120 pi times t, to equal this angle 4 pi over 3. We'll multiply each side by the reciprocal, 1 over 120 pi. And we find out that t is equal to, well, we need to do some reducing over here on the right-hand side. The pi's will cancel, and 4 goes into 120 30 times, so we're going to get that t is equal to 1 over 90 seconds.